can you explain just a little bit about each one of those top three coins? Or just like, just I guess breaking it down in simple terms, the technology side of it.
Okay, I would just say like Bitcoin, if you want to talk about the technology of it, transactions are verified and put placed into a block. And all a block is that if you can imagine a spreadsheet, okay? And if you, you know, you look at a spreadsheet, it has rows and columns. So on this thing, let's just say that our block has 100 rows. So every single row, row one all the way to 100, is gonna be a transaction, me transferring value back to you. When we get to row 101, we're gonna click the tab at the bottom. You know, on the spreadsheet, you click it and create a new sheet, mm-hmm. Okay? And then every 10 minutes, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna fill it up with transactions and create a new sheet or a new block. We put those blocks on top of each other and we call it a blockchain. That's what's verified every 10 minutes to make sure that all the accounts balance every 10 minutes. Okay, that happens. That's called your confirmation or your block time. With Bitcoin is 10 minutes. With Litecoin and Bearcoin, it's 2.5 minutes. With Bitcoin, you have a total volume of all the Bitcoins that are ever gonna be created is 21 million. And you say, wow. If you look at it in dollars, you say, well, if there's only $21 million that we could ever have, how would that work? You know, but you can take a dollar and split it how many times? 100.
Yeah.
Okay, and each one of those units is a penny or 1 cent. Mm-hmm. You can take one Bitcoin and split it 100 million times. Mm-hmm. And that lowest denominator is called a Satoshi. Okay, that's why you can have, that's why people call me, oh, I can't get into Bitcoin, it's 11,000, I don't have 11,000. No, you can buy 10 cents worth of Bitcoin,
right,
or you can buy $10,000 worth of Bitcoin, or whatever. You can buy it in units as little as 100 million, okay? Also, another thing is, you have, you say, well, where do Bitcoins come from, okay? Every 10 minutes, new Bitcoin are created automatically to get us to that 21 million, okay? So, the first 4 years, every 10 minutes, that block reward, and what our block reward is our first transaction in each one of those sheets, which is, it at that time, it was 50 Bitcoin, mm-hmm. plus whatever the miner who created that charged in fees, mm-hmm. okay? Every 10 minutes, for the first 4 years, or 210,000 blocks, okay? Then after that, it cut in half, and it was 25 Bitcoin every 10 minutes, plus the fees. Now we're in the third halving, which is 12.5 Bitcoin every 10 minutes, okay? The, back then, if you got 50 Bitcoin, Bitcoin would probably worth 5 cents a piece, so. But now if you get 12.5 Bitcoin, 12.5, yeah, I don't even want to do the math on that. That's every 10 minutes, okay?
Yeah.
Also what you have is you got more machines doing this work and creating or being a part of the network. Okay, the more machines you get into it, in theory, that will drive that 10-minute window down because you got more machines working on the same problem. The network automatically does something called increases its difficulty rate. So the network is...
So when will you know a mature fully, like the actual Bitcoin?
Well, you get 21 million Bitcoins in the year 2140.
Well, I think it's 16 million because 4 million was stolen, right?
Well, they're still on the block.
Oh.
The Bitcoin weren't stolen. The keys were stolen.
Right. Mm.
You steal those keys, if you don't have the keys, it's not your Bitcoin.